This summer, I've noticed wood dust on our hickory tree. I've washed it away and it reappears in a few days. It seems to be coming from up above. What could be causing this? And this is Mike from Ringgold, Georgia. Hickory trees, and of course, the first thing that came to my mind, maybe a bore?
Some type of wood bore? Yes, I don't see any exit holes on this picture here, but that fine sawdust is a little heavier than what carpenter ants would make.
Okay.
So I would, going by this picture, in my experience, I would say that this tree is infested with ambrosia borers, which there's three or four different types.
Oh yeah.
The granulated ambrosia borer will lead the toothpick type sawdust that comes out. It'll attack newly transplanted trees, small trees, Japanese maples, cherry trees, and like that. So the tree does not have to be stressed. This type of ambrosia borer, and I'm going by species of tree too, hickory, there is some stress going on. The ambrosia borer that makes this much sawdust generally attacks trees that are either dying, diseased, or severely stressed.
Oh, okay.
When they get to, when a tree gets to that point, it emits a gas, like a ethanol type gas, that attracts the borers to the tree. Wow. Like this.
So it brings more on. Oh, how about that?
Lunch is served.
Right.
And so when these borers, the adults, bore all through the vascular tissue of the tree, not only are they creating holes and separating that vascular tissue, that xylem and phloem tissue, but they're creating like a fungal garden inside those tunnels. It's really interesting. And that fungus that they grow in those tunnels feeds the adults and the growing larvae inside there. So you have to act quick to hire a certified arborist to spray this tree with a permethrin type insecticide, and you need a spreader sticker to go mixed in with that, that chemical, so it stays on the tree and continues to control this beetle. If this ambrosia borer is not controlled, the tree would probably die.
Probably eventually die. Wow. Yeah. How about that? And I guess, you know, spraying for that tree, you know, there's a window, right?
There is a window. You don't have very much time with this. If you can picture taking and cutting that bark off that tree, so there's no nutrient flow, there's no sap flow, that's basically what's happening underneath the bark.
Yeah.
You're just cutting that tree in half, all that tissue.
Wow. So no water and nutrients to the upper canopy.
Mm-hmm. Or the lower.
Lower.
There's no transportation whatsoever.
Thanks for watching. If you liked it, subscribe. We have hundreds of family plot videos for you to view.